Misters, we're back. Hey. I brought my pencil. Give me something to write on.
Students, today our class is about the band Alice in Chains with the song Man in the Box from their album Facelift from 1990. This is not their first album, but this is a very important album. From that very album begins their big journey. Now look at this, We Die Young, Man in the Box, Bleed the Freak, Love, Hate, Love, Confusion. So we begin and no complain, because if we're gonna complain, you know that we're not gonna have a deal. And you remember that you need to remember the rules, so you don't remember that you need to remember the rules. Okay, I know some, you know, people, they like born to be a scientist, and then they inventing that pills for memory, and then they like consumed by these corporations and all these prescriptions. But you kinda can go to like Walgreens, you know, and buy that pills for memory, because somebody was born to make you memorize that we have a serious contract here. Okay, Man in the Box, Man in the Box. I tricked you. You thought we're gonna listen to Horus? No, 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 no. 1 minute break, 1 minute break, 1 minute break. In our class we do so. Yes, 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 student, remember you told me that you have kind of memory problem, remember? Oh, you don't remember, you, because you have a memory problem, so I remind you. So you have a memory problem, and we, yes, stopping because of copyrights. Alice in Chains actually was formed in 1987, and this album just 3 years later, which I think successful, very successful story, because for some bands it takes a decade. So 2 years later, after forming the band, they already signed a big contract with Columbia Records in 1989. And they released first EP with We Die Young, and 1990s, little bit later, they included the song We Die Young in the album Facelift.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Elaine's voice, because it's controversial beauty. Some people would consider it being not pleasant for the ear, that very tone, like that is he definitely has that very unique timbre, very recognizable. And of course Jerry compliments so much. I think that main figure in the band is Jerry, since his big contribution in the songwriting, and still we have lead singer. I really like his voice, genuinely love his tone. He just knows how to express what he feels inside, or what somebody feels inside. And it sounds weird, like, isn't it everybody should do that? No, guys, not much people know how to do that. It's a talent, it's a gift. It's not something what you can go and learn, how do you know to sing notes and pitch this note and like go to that Ken Templin I never watched his videos, by the way, but fragments just give me that. Yeah, my belief. If you don't know how to sing completely, if you don't have that gift, you maybe succeed in this in some level, but you're gonna be fake. I know that people. I know that people. They have talent to build a beautiful sound. The structure of their melody, of singing melody. Hey, 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 my eye. You know? Hey, like making it wide range. Well, the lyrics of the song actually explained by Jerry in one of the interviews. He said that they went out of dinner with vegetarians and they told Alice in Chains that the veal made from baby cow raised in the box. So basically baby cow all her life don't see anything but only that shed that she eating. This what was basically a kind of idea of the song. But when the Elaine Staley sings that, you also can apply this meaning into the person. Actually lyricist is Elaine and composer is Jerry. While Elaine wrote the lyrics, he was wasted. As we all know, he was drug addict and he was very sick. Unfortunately, in that kind of stage that you rarely get out of it. We'll be right back. actually, but if you don't think about the meaning and don't listen the lyrics, you can catch the different mood of it. Because it's not feels for me depressed. When we talk about the big four of the grunge Seattle kind of bands, Alice in Chains, Nirvana, Pearl Jam and Soundgarden, I would say that these four bands producing different kind of energies. One band, they are rebellious, like, I'm gonna fight for human rights. This is bullshit, this is na-na-na. Another band, I would say, I'm not gonna tell which one, but they are so depressed that, like, suicidal, you know? That kind of energy that I just don't want to listen. They have super quality of the music and the vocalist and musicianship, whatever, but the energy of that band so far from me. The band number three actually kind of giving me the vibe of healthy people, you know, even they are grungy and kind of melancholic, but they are healthy guys. And Alice in Chains is that very band which I would say they are moody, dramatic, very like sad but beautiful, so beautiful. From all these four, I would choose Alice in Chains. That combination of the voices and the drama behind his concert, when he just sitting, you know, that MTV unplugged, concentrated on the performance, you see the person in pain, that pain in the soul, and that addiction that he has not gives him like, oh, I'm a drug addict because I like the effect of drugs. No, he was just already consumed by it and didn't know how to get out. There are many of them who has that story, but I kind of feel in his voice this pain with that special bond. I feel it. He's comparing himself with an animal that living in the box. He's like feeling, I never get out of it unless I'll die, you know? And yet it's not sounds suicidal for me. It sounds just depressed, moody, dramatic, very sad. There is a quote that Lane said, I'm not using drugs to get high like many people think. I know I made a big mistake when I started using that shit. It's a very difficult thing to explain. My liver is not functioning and I'm throwing up all the time and shit in my pants. The pain is more than you can handle. It's the worst pain in the world. Dope sick hurts the entire body. I don't want to sound like a saint here, guys, because I'm not feel genuine connection with every musician who died early. Honestly, obviously sad stories when people die young, but with him I feel that special connection. Just with that energy I feel connection and I feel very sad. It's very sad that he had this kind of life, you know. Since the topic of this class is a Facelift album, my personal choice from the Facelift would be a Bleed the Freak. Blood from a stone. Song, it's energy that lifts me up, and that rebellious and that kind of anger at that stupid society that just so stupid to label everybody, to put that shame on somebody's dreams, to blame, criticize out of their stupidity and fears. And I love that he is just expressing that anger. Well, I like Love Hate Love, but I also reviewed it. I actually also really love Confusion.
Yeah.
that kind of melody. He can go from the high to low in just one word, which is, I would say, kind of signature. Okay, guys, congratulations, our class is finished and you can go have a break and play hide and seek and eat your cookies and ice cream. But watch the calories, okay, because that's a summer camp and you need to go on the beach and be naked, okay? Because whales and dolphins, they are naked, right? So, and sea and ocean is their environment, their rules. So you need to participate in their rules, okay? Bye-bye.